Thank you very much, Carissa. Certainly
tough to argue with that one, yes.
Yeah. Well, big news on Wednesday, Dan, involving Johnny Manziel. I can't even keep a straight face about it.
It's one of the strangest suspensions in recent memory, maybe ever.
Yeah.
Because they came down on the Heisman winner.
I thought that Mike Pereira on Fox Football Daily had the best point of all on Wednesday when he said that basically they just gave Texas A&M a big boost going into the second half when Johnny Manziel comes out onto the field and the entire crowd is excited and thrilled to see him. Yeah, Johnny Manziel has been suspended for the first half of the season opener against Rice on Saturday. That's right, just the first half. The suspension is for, quote, an inadvertent violation related to the signing of certain autographs. He also said there's no evidence Manziel ever received money in exchange for signing memorabilia. Fox Sports analyst Jen Engel has more from College Station.
The sense is that Johnny Manziel was let off the hook by the NCAA when they only gave him a half-game suspension. But talking to people down here at A&M, they say the NCAA was lucky to get even that. Why? There was no evidence that Johnny took money for his autograph. The only person they were able to talk to was Johnny, and he fervently denied it. He also came at this from a position of power. He hired a lawyer. They were at the table, and they made it clear if the NCAA or the school tried to suspend him without evidence, they would do whatever necessary to get the Heisman Trophy winning quarterback back on the field. The one thing we know he is guilty of is that he was an off-field distraction. He will be forced to address the team, apologize to coaches, talk about what he learns. The real apologizing, though, will begin when he takes the field. From College Station, I'm Jen Engel.
Jen, thank you. And Texas A&M Chancellor John Sharp issued this statement. I'm proud of the way both Coach Sumlin and Johnny handled this situation with integrity and honesty. We all take the Aggie Code of Honor very seriously. There's no evidence that either the university or Johnny violated that code.
Cassio Puig misses cutoff man. He's like a car with no brakes on the base paths. He's late to the ballpark in Miami. Puig is 22. He's doing things 22-year-olds do. But it's really annoying the Dodgers, and it came to a head Wednesday afternoon in L.A. So let's see what happens here. I'll tell you how it played out. Bottom one, Puig on first. Carl Crawford. Okay, hits one to second. Puig doesn't slide to break up the double play. It's a 4-6-3 double play. Puig went in standing up. Okay, so he could have broken that up. Instead, Hanley Ramirez steps up. He's the next batter. Nobody on. And puts it into someone's lap. His 15th of the year. Dodgers up 1-0. The fourth, Anthony Rizzo, the former Jerky Boy, lifts one into right. Puig makes the catch, takes his time with it. Okay, nonchalanting it. Two batters later, one more sent Puig's way. Now people were discussing this because Puig doesn't transfer it and just throws it into the crowd. Hey, that was odd, and Puig then pulled from the game. Mattingly said Skip Schumacher gave them a better chance to win. Schumacher singles, run comes in to score. Dodgers up 4-0. No questioning Skip's hustle. Eighth inning, Ricky Nolasco. He went 8 scoreless in his last start. Logan Watkins at the dish. Looks at strike 3. Darwin Barney can't check. Nolasco, 8 scoreless innings once again with 11 strikeouts. Dodgers win 4-0.
I like Yasiel. I think he's a great player. And I want the best for him, and I want the best for our team. And so I get back to the same thing. I'm putting Skip out there to give us the best chance to win today.
No me está preparando bien en el outfield y estuvo bien la decisión y decidieron que mi compañero Chumaco tuviera mi posición.
No, it's that he wasn't preparing well for each pitch, and it was a good decision. It's actually that was the case, and he mentioned that he felt Shoemaker could come in and do a better job.
Okay, so there's no denying the Puig produces when he's in. At least the team does. Look at that winning percentage with Puig, and a tweet was sent out by Dodgers Nation saying, "Yasiel Puig was benched for more of a game than Johnny Football will be." The translator, by the way, his voice sounded a lot like Super Dave. Trying to place the voice, and I finally came up with it. Audi Big Board shows you the American League East and the battle that's raging. The Red Sox sitting on top of the heap. Mid-season acquisition Bud Norris trying to help the Orioles return to the playoffs, though. First inning, Dustin Pedroia chops one towards third. Norris charges. That is a pretty play. Made it look simple. It is not bare hands. In one motion, goes to first. Got him. By a good 20 feet. Third inning. Norris facing David Ortiz with the bases loaded. Norris gets him swinging. Next batter, Daniel Nava. Looking out of the jam. Norris finished with 7 strikeouts and 5 and a third. Sixth inning. Chris Davis has lumber.
Here is Chris Davis leading it off against Lackey. First ball hitting, drives it in the air, right center field. That's that deep well. And goodbye, home run! Catches the corner about 400 feet away. And Chris Davis launches yet another one.
That's number 47 for Davis. Remember, Miggy Cabrera is chasing him as Cabrera goes for the triple crown. Seventh inning, Sox down 2. Pedroia at the plate with 2 on. Doubles off Darren O'Day. Steven Drew and Jacoby Ellsbury both in to score. Red Sox tie the game at 3. Eighth inning, Mike Karp. No relation to Mike Trout. Pinch hitting. Fly ball off Tommy Hunter. Manny Machado can't make the play. Jared Saltamacchia comes in and scores. The Red Sox win 4-3. The Rays trailing the Sox by 2.5 going into action on Wednesday. David Price ready for some college football, sporting the helmet of his alma mater, Vanderbilt, and then checking to see if the helmet works. Fourth inning, David DeJesus. Comeback route, Garrett Richards. Desmond Jennings comes home to score. Richards stayed in the game for 2 more batters, then left. Rays up 2-0. Fifth inning, rookie Chris Archer. He's looking for his 8th win. Chris Iannetta, roller. Yanel Escobar, covering ground. Throw to first. Got him. Rays win 4-1.
All right, let's check out the A's and Tigers, Dan. Miguel Cabrera's reached base in 30 straight games, longest active streak in the majors. Third inning, A's up 3-1. Cabrera off Dan Straley. Holds it first for the single, has now reached base in 31 straight games and 120 of the 125 games he has played this season. But this one is really all Oakland. It's already 8-1 in the sixth when Brandon Moss hits his 23rd of the year. That makes it 10-1 Oakland. And then in the eighth, this will make Gary Payton happy. Moss with the second of the game. He was 4-for-5, 6 RBIs. A's win big, 14-4.
Indians and Braves. Dan Uglow, 1-for-30 in his last 9 games before having LASIK eye surgery. Okay, so he's back off the DL. Oh, missed that pitch by about 8 feet. He struck out twice in his return. More work on the eyes needed. Maybe call up Dr. Nick. Fourth inning, Carlos Santana. Hits it into center. B.J. Upton makes the catch. Did not have to dive, yet he did. Nice play. Eighth inning, game tied at 2. Runners on the corner, 2 out. Michael Brantley. Foul tip right into the glove of Brian McCann. As Drubal Cabrera going to second, he gets caught in a rundown, and Cabrera tagged out by Andrelton Simmons. Cabrera thought it was fouled off and into the dirt.
He thought the ball was fouled into the dirt. It wasn't.
Braves out of jet. Ninth inning, still tied at 2. Runner on second. Chris Johnson at the dish. Johnson finds a hole. Brantley, like a carsick toddler, comes up hurling. Jordan Schaefer beats the throw. Johnson with his first career walk-off hit. Braves improved to 46-18 at home as they take it 3-2.
Jays and Yankees. Eduardo Nunez. What's going on there? Well, let's go back to Tuesday.
It's awful difficult for us.
Rolls his ankle. Exactly. He's right defensive play. Oh, he's down. And on Wednesday, Jahvid Chamberlain and Vernon Wells making hilarious truck outline indicating his death. First inning, no score. Edwin Encarnacion grounds one sharply to short. Derek Jeter from his knees. 6,333 career assists. That's the most among active players. 39 years old, getting it done. Later in the inning, Jays up 2-0 after a two-run double by Brett Laurie. Hiroki Kuroda, strikes out JPR and Sevilla. Chris Stewart can't handle the pitch. Ball goes all the way to the backstop. Stewart throw to first, hits Aaron Sevilla, goes down the line. Laurie and Rajay Davis score. A bizarre sequence of events puts the Jays up 4-0. So go to the fourth, Jays up 7-1 after an A-Rod RBI single. Mark Reynolds replacing the injured Nunez sends a deep to the wall off Todd Redmond. Jays couldn't get sponsorship there. They just put up a sign that says their team name. It's pretty embarrassing, actually. A-Rod gone at the plate. Ryan Goins to relay throw. We go to the fifth. Jays up 7-2. Stewart sends one to shallow center. Anthony Goats. The line on this kid is he's got speed, and yep, I'd say so. Running full speed makes a sensational defensive play, and the Blue Jays have taken 2 of 3 from the Yankees. So we take a look at the American League wildcard standings. That means the Yankees now 5.5 back in the AL wildcard. The Indians lose, the Orioles lose, so it's great news for the Rays and the A's, a full 4 games up on the Cleave for the wildcard.
When Texas A&M and the NCAA announced Johnny Manziel's suspension for the first half of the team's season opener against Rice, they initially were selling a photo of Manziel that ran with the announcement on their website. They've since removed that option. So the website design class at Texas A&M, Google won't have you, but I'm sure AOL will. Here's Chris in the panel with more on Manziel.
You can't make it up every single day. Today, half a game suspension. Clay Travis, our college football insider, with us now. How bad does the NCAA look now, Clay?
Awful. The NCAA, I said before, an awful, awful organization. Wow. I mean, look, everybody makes money off of Johnny Manziel, including A&M, as they're announcing that he suspended a half game. I mean, it's ridiculous. The absurdity of the NCAA just knows no bounds, and we see it again and again. They don't service the best interest of the kids. They exist, guys, right, to make sure that if you're poor when you come into the league, when you come in to start playing college sports, you remain poor after you leave. That's fundamentally anti-capitalistic. Every one of everybody else out there can sell their labor at 18, except for football players, men's basketball players.
Like, was this the worst thing that could have happened to Johnny Manziel? In my mind, you need to give him like a harsher punishment. Half a game suspension, does that really teach him the lesson that he needs to learn here?
No, he hasn't learned any lesson at all. What he's learned is he can outsmart the NCAA, and a lot of the criticism of Johnny Manziel in general has been, it comes from a wealthy family. Right. If he goes out and hires this big-time attorney, he can beat the NCAA too. The rules, it would seem, don't apply to him, mm-hmm, literally.
How hypocritical would it be if 5 years from now, they look back and all of a sudden they're giving these athletes money every semester to try to help them lead into budgeting and being.
How much would you have liked that?
Oh, I would have loved that. I would have loved that.
I mean, now.
Yeah, I'd like it now. No, I mean, I think that's where they're going to have to move. It's instead of having this system, which is completely a fallacy, which is if you're a women's lacrosse player, that you were treated the exact same as Johnny Manziel.
Right.
Under NCAA rules, you are. You get the same scholarship. They're going to have to realize with billions of dollars at stake, A&M made $37 million off Johnny Manziel last year. Those guys need to be able to make something for their own talents instead of having to subsidize other athletes who aren't as well.
How many people up here think that players should be paid in college?
Oh, me, definitely.
Okay, so everyone's out of
there. I don't think, maybe, I'm against the stipend model, but you should be able to get paid for your likeness. Like, if Johnny Manziel is more famous than everyone else, during, out of season, I feel like he should be able to sell autographs.
Did anyone's opinion change of Johnny Manziel from yesterday to today?
No.
Okay.
I don't know what actually happened, but the fact that he went to someone's room and signed a bunch of autographs just because he was bored?
Multiple times? Yeah.
Either that or he needs a hobby. I don't know.
Are you guys rolling into a guy's room that you don't know?
No, absolutely not.
4,400 autographs out of the decency of your heart. I think that's kind of the thing people can't get past. The bigger issue here, I think, that's broader for both the NCAA and everyone else is, what if Jadeveon Clowney had done this?
Exactly.
What if Braxton Miller had done this? What if other big-time athletes had done this, and I think they may have because they are also authenticated autographs were for sale. How would we have responded? I don't know.
Do you think it's a race issue?
I think that there is an element there. I think that to a certain extent, people are willing to give Johnny Manziel a pass because they feel like he represents something like they would have been like in
college. Do you think it's a race issue, or do you just think that it's a big money issue, the fact that he comes from money, therefore he can hire this all-star lawyer firm?
I think it's almost inextricable here when you go with class and race. Yeah. I'm curious. How do you think people
I think it's respond? Definitely a class situation where now we won't look back at Johnny Manziel because of the financial wealth of his family, but if it was Jadeveon Clowney, then we would go deeper into it because of the economic aspect. Yes, there's a racial deal into this. It's not so deep as we think, but it still plays a part in this because, you know, you would think he wouldn't have to do that, or he's going into these autograph sessions and he's not getting paid, maybe because he doesn't need the money. Well, according to, I guess, a videotape or whatever on a camera phone, he said he's doing it pretty much to get rims on his new Benz. Well, what else do you need to know? If you can't get rims on your new Benz that your dad just bought you, then you're using the money that you're receiving. And I think it's unfair because the NCAA understands this. They can't trace the money, but what more do you need? Maybe the money's going elsewhere, whatever it may be, but I think it's truly unfair of what's going on right now with this whole Johnny Manziel situation and suspend him for a half. That's just ridiculous.
Dez Bryant got 10 games for lying to the NCAA. Johnny Manziel walked into that six-hour meeting and was armed with all the ammunition he needed because he said, yes, I've done this, I've done this, I've done this, because it was all out there.
That's a huge point, Carissa. I mean, everybody got upset about the way that this story was covered, but really, it actually really helped, guys, because if you know the goods they've got on you already, you come in and you admit only to the things that don't get you in trouble, and then you bounce and you say, no, no, no. Johnny Manziel, he beat the NCAA.
Clay Travis, our college football insider, thanks for the time.
Appreciate it.
We're taking a break here on Fox Sports Live, but the Dodgers call it a manager's discretion. To the baseball world, it's a benching. What's next for Don Mattingly and Yasiel Puig? College football season, you can't tell, it is upon us. And we'll get you ready for opening weekend and a whole lot more. That's all coming up next, as well as Mark Sanchez. He sits down with our own Mike Garofolo. That's next on Fox Sports Live.
My dad wasn't going.
College football is on Fox Sports 1.
Wow!
It all kicks off with the Ford Fox College Football pregame show. Then the games begin with West Virginia's home opener. Oregon's high-powered offense takes the field, and Boise State clashes with Washington. Catch all the action this week, starting at 10 Eastern on Fox Sports 1.
Can be detrimental, t-shirt to panty, that's your credential, your cotton candy, I need a fist for I'm off the antsy, hope that convince you.
Hey, girl, you know you're looking so different, you're looking like you fell from the sky,
angel,
you know you make a grown man cry, I wanna give it to you.
Golden Corral just made the weekend better than ever again. Our $12.99 premium prime rib and shrimp weekend is back. It's endless prime rib, our best jumbo butterfly shrimp, and our new bone-in catfish and catfish fillets. It's our premium prime rib and shrimp weekend only at Golden Corral.
When do you crave refreshing iced tea? Twisted Tea wants to know. The next time you want that same satisfying refreshment, but with a kick, grab a Twisted Tea. Twisted Tea, the refreshing hard iced tea that tastes like real iced tea with a kick.
Make it look beautiful. Make it look beautiful. Good, good. That's nice. Very nice. Great stuff.
Here's Ryan Newman in the number 39 Quicken Loan Chevy. Now, what are we looking at there?
Well, the last time Ryan Newman finished in the top five, Quicken Loans made a mortgage payment for these five folks.
Are you serious?
Yep, they entered the Quicken Loans Bring It Home Sweepstakes, and they won. Every time Ryan Newman gets a top five finish, Quicken Loans will make a mortgage payment for five lucky winners. Enter at QLRacing.com, and you could be one of them.
Boogity, boogity, boogity. Bring it home, Ryan.
If there's one truth in this life, you can't escape your demons. I thought I hung my tire chains up for good, but I can't shake this bad feeling that I haven't seen the last of my old friend.
Monday Night Fights on Fox Sports 1. Luis Collazo stares down Alan Sanchez. Monday on Fox Sports 1.
Yes, indeed. You're watching Fox Sports Live, a show that's apparently just a stepping stone on the road to stardom for Ephraim Salaam.
What's this? On Wednesday, the news broke that Ephraim will compete on season 23 of The Amazing Race.
It's true. At the end of September. Thanks for inviting us, Ephraim.
I can't believe they've had 23 seasons. That's a long-running show.
It's given that Kiwi a job for a long time.
Rex Ryan said Tuesday he hopes to have wide receiver Santonio Holmes back in the Jets lineup in time for the team's season opener September 8th. Holmes has not played since injuring his foot in week 4 last season. Participated in limited practices Monday and Tuesday.
Robert Kraft, the Patriots owner, responded Wednesday to an NFL Players Union grievance that the Pats owe $82,000 to Aaron Hernandez in unpaid workout bonuses. Kraft said, quote, "We honor all of our contracts. We expect the people who sign them to honor their part of the contract."
An article in the latest edition of Rolling Stone magazine accuses Aaron Hernandez of heavy drug use and gang-related activities while a member of the Patriots last season. The Fox Football Daily crew sat down with the Rolling Stone writer who penned the article on Wednesday.
Aaron Hernandez had been a chronic smoker going back to year one in Florida. About 14 months ago, according to my sources in Bristol, he switched over to Angel Dust, became dependent, if not in fact addicted to it, and as the year wore on, became increasingly badly behaved and paranoid to the point of being kind of lethally violent to whoever he was around.
Wow. Do not question Brandon Phillips' on-base percentage. A Cincinnati reporter did just that Wednesday after Phillips was moved from cleanup to second in the order, and Phillips went off on the scribe during Dusty Baker's pregame media session.
Hey, Dusty, the fat on the end, he worries about my on-base percentage. Don't you tell him. Have me bat eight, though you worry about my on-base percentage.
I don't care.
Fat about dog. Make him happy, Dusty. Fat
mother. Tell you talk that negative team, dog. I find out your Twitter name now, mother. It's a wrap. Wow. Took you how many years? Congratulations.
I ain't in there. That's between you and him.
Sounded like a truck backing up. The beeps were so consistent. Brandon Phillips and the Reds are 4.5 games behind the Cards in the NL Central. Phillips first at bat, single off Adam Wainwright. Phillips finished 2-for-5 in his new spot in order. Bases loaded. Jay Bruce facing Wainwright. Singles. Chu and Phillips score. Reds lead 2-0. Ryan Ludwig with a double off Wainwright. Joey Votto scores. Reds up 3-0. Wainwright wild pitch. Ludwig scores. Reds up 5-0. Homer Bailey singles to center off Wainwright. Zach Cozart scores. Reds scored 6 in the inning. Wainwright was looking to become the first NL pitcher with 16 victories. And when I say Wainwright, I mean Wainwright. Second inning, struggles continue. Jay Bruce takes Wainwright to Tappy Town. Population, boom. 26 of the season. Wainwright gives up 9 earned runs, the most in his career.
All right, so that's good news for the Reds. What about the Pirates? They have struggled in the month of August the last 3 seasons, and this year is no exception. Their only saving grace may be the fact that their pitching is much better this year. In fact, their team ERA is second in the major leagues. So they go into their game against Milwaukee, a game and a half back of St. Louis for first in the Central. As you saw, St. Louis just lost, so a chance to gain some ground. Marlon Byrd just joined the Mets Tuesday and lines up with pitcher Tom Gorzelin. Box up one zip, fourth inning. Pedro Alvarez shoots one to second. Scooter Jeanette lays out, makes a stop, and nice throw to first for the out. Great play by Jeanette. Seventh inning. Byrd.
In the air to center field, way back to the wall, and let's go flying with Marlon Byrd. Welcome to the Berg, Mr. Byrd.
Gets his first home run with Pittsburgh, and the Pirates win 7-1.
Okay, so the St. Louis lost. Pittsburgh Cincy winners, so they gained some ground. Reds snapped that 3-game losing streak in the process. Reds and Cards begin a 4-game series in Cincy Monday. The Cards and Pirates begin a series in Pittsburgh on Friday.
Three
2-2 pitch. Queen goes as a hopper to the right side. They throw to second.
Your only thought is to break up a double play in that situation, and the only way to do it is to slide.
Queen has come out of the game.
Then I felt like Skip was going to give us a better chance to win today, and that's why I did it.
Why? He had walked, he had struck out, he handled a couple of fly balls in right field.
Really talented guy, but doesn't have a real understanding of the nuances of the game.
I'm not doing it to hurt him. I'm not doing it to try to do anything that would hurt him or his reputation.
And we get a terse report. It was a manager's decision.
You know, I have to represent the whole ball club with some decisions that I make. I like Yasiel. I think he's a great player. And I want the best for him, and I want the best for our team.
So Yasiel Puig benched on Wednesday. Did Mattingly make the right move?
Absolutely. Yasiel Puig had an opportunity to put Starlin Castro into left field on a double play and stood up. So not only that, but he was playing lackadaisical defense. He wasn't all there. Mattingly had to make a move here and show his team that he wasn't going to accept this sort of half-hearted effort on behalf of Yasiel Puig.
So we talked about this just a few weeks ago when he was down in Miami. He showed up late for a team meeting. Mattingly said that it was a baseball move, yada, yada, yada. We get it. Overall, have the Dodgers as a team handled this kid in the right way?
When the Dodgers signed Yasiel Puig, they put Tim Bravo on the case. Tim Bravo acted sort of as a mentor to Yasiel. They became very, very close. They spent a lot of time together. Bravo provided nutritional advice. He provided sort of how to be a man off the field and to assimilate into our culture. And he did a really nice job. Since then, on July 14th, the two parted ways. The Dodgers and Bravo decided he was going to go back and do some teaching, and so they haven't been together.
So what was Bravo's relationship with the Dodgers prior to this? Where did they find him?
Bravo was sort of, he acted as a guy that would help Latin players assimilate. He has a good understanding of the Spanish language and sort of acted as a mentor on behalf of some
of
the Latin players.
And so why did they get rid of him? Is that clear?
It's not clear at this point why they got rid of him. The only thing that is clear is that since his departure, Yasiel has been sort of a lost puppy or a wild horse. He's been making reckless decisions off the field. You had the Playboy Mansion thing. You had the showing up late thing. And now you have a guy who's not all there on the field. So he's clearly looking for somebody to come in and discipline him.
You don't think the two are coincidental at all?
I don't. I think they're absolutely linked in some way. And I think Yasiel is really crying out for help, for somebody to say, hey, I need somebody to show me how to do this right.
His talent is unparalleled. What now for him?
Well, this isn't going away anytime soon for the Dodgers. Yasiel Puig is going to continue to pop up until they make the right move. And I think they're getting closer to actually laying down the smack on him, but they're not there yet.
Hard to do that with a talented player. Gabe, thanks for your insight on that. We send it over to the desk with some tennis news.
For the first 2 days of the U.S. Open, I've been referencing the fact that we have a guy who won the tournament sitting right next to us. So we are taking advantage of that.
By having Andy Roddick remain seated far away from us. Because Andy has a rash. Sweden's Sofia Arvidsson. Boy, Andy's not going to be happy with us. Taking on fifth seed Li Na of China. First set after a short cross-court run. And Na takes first set 6-2. Second set, Li Na. Li Na Na. 6-2, 6-2. She wins in straight sets.
We can tell you James Blake lost his match. Said he's retiring for this U.S. Open.
Probably should have mentioned that off the top instead of Andy's rash.
Like industrial excavators, its brake rotors are hardened with a heat-treating process that can double their life. And like the Hoover Dam, its engine makes power when it's needed and conserves fuel when it isn't, making it the most fuel-efficient V8 in a pickup, even beating Ford's EcoBoost V6. So it's only fitting that we'd have the confidence to equip the all-new GMC Sierra with ProGrade Protection, the best coverage available on a pickup, including 2 years of scheduled maintenance. That's professional grade.
In my playing days, I was known for keeping calm in the face of chaos. But now, I'm more relaxed than ever, thanks to my new Relax Fit shoes from Skechers.
My purse! Somebody help me, please!
They keep you relaxed in any situation.
New Relax Fit Skechers.
At some point in the many lives of a dollar, it will be a dollar saved by somebody who switched to Esurance. Like dollar karma. Being online, Esurance saves dollars that come back as more dollars for you. Esurance. Now backed by Allstate. Click or call.
I talk big, right? And at the dealership, I was trying to hold my own, and it's kind of tough.
TrueCar really took the anxiety out of the car buying process.
When you use TrueCar.com, you get a certificate, and it shows you a fair price.
I felt confident going in on my own and closing the deal on my own.
TrueCar makes it a lot easier to go in by yourself. I don't need to bring a dude with me.
When buying a need savings and a hassle-free experience, visit TrueCar.com.
Oh no, you broke your line again? So you'll wind and wind. What a waste of time. But no more. Introducing the Pivot Trim, the first trimmer head that keeps your line from breaking, saving you time and money. Just watch. Even banging it on pavers, edging around driveways, and smashing into walls won't break the line. It's even strong enough to cut right through plywood without breaking a single line. The secret is in the patented pivot action that protects the trimmer line. You can get the Pivot Trim today for only $19.95. It comes complete with a universal installation kit and 20 pre-cut trimmer lines. But hold everything. We'll guarantee you free trimmer line for life. We'll also include the three-blade head free. Just pay separate processing and handling. The three-blade head synthetic blades slice through the tough stuff, from saplings to the thickest overgrown brush quickly, cutting them down to size in no time. You'll get it all. Call now.
To order Pivot Trim for $19.95 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-849-4603. Again, that's 1-800-849-4603. Or order online at pivottrim.com.
College football is on Fox Sports 1 as Utah takes on Utah State. It all kicks off tomorrow with the Ford Fox College Football pregame show.
Time for LiveWire. Look at the biggest stories right now. Yasiel Puig was benched after four innings in Wednesday's game against the Cubs. Puig was removed at manager Don Mattingly's discretion, not because of injury. Here's Mattingly discussing the decision to pull Puig. Or not.
Texas A&M quarterback Johnny Manziel will be suspended for the first half of A&M's season opener Saturday against Rice. That's right, suspended for the first half. Suspension is for, quote, an inadvertent violation related to the signing of certain autographs. There is no evidence Manziel ever received money in exchange for signing memorabilia.
It is the first weekend in September, and it's time to clear your Saturdays. It is happening. The color, the wonder, the explosiveness, the tribal nature. College football is here, and everybody's talking about Johnny Manziel, the magician out there running around, Jadeveon Clowney. What about the statue that is Alabama? Are they beatable? Should we build the statue now? Nobody's talking about USC this year. Is Michigan even Michigan? Is Ohio State going to roll over the entire Big Ten? You got angry coaches. Nick Saban and his feathered hair. Urban Meyer and his frown. And don't look past teams like Northwestern and TCU. And don't sleep in on Saturday. College football season, and it's only just beginning.
Petro's voicing that. What a beauty he is. He'll be joining you guys in studio for college football coverage throughout the year. Clay Travis, stuck around with us because football season is upon us. Opening game of the college football season starts tomorrow. He's Mr. SEC. So, Donovan, start us off.
It's time to put you to the test. You know, Connor Shaw, he's holding down the offense. He'll be the leader on that side. And then, obviously, DeValey and Clowney. Do you think they'll be the first team to knock off Alabama in the SEC championship?
I hope so. I hope it gets interesting like that because I want that game to be a default play-in. I actually think Georgia's more likely to beat South Carolina and actually win the SEC East, and then we get a rematch of last year's SEC championship game, Georgia and Alabama.
Why do you say that?
I just think that, first, Georgia has the home game, so they get to play against South Carolina, even though South Carolina's won the last couple.
That's a buzzer. That means our time up. Sorry, I did a follow-up. That doesn't really count. You should get more time.
They said 20 seconds. Carissa, you killed me there. You led me over the middle. I got flattened.
We got USC Hawaii tomorrow. Now, there seems to be some growing resentment towards Lane Kiffin already. I tried to say it nicely. From Trojan Nation, what does he have to accomplish this year to keep the fans happy at USC?
He has to go 11-2.
Wow.
And that means he can only lose to Notre Dame and to Stanford. Anything worse than that,
think
I think
gone.
Lane Kiffin
anything
is in really big trouble. They play 13 games, so he gets an extra. But, yeah, he has to go 11-2.
But he's so likable.
Good one.
Thank you.
Yeah.
A game on our air tomorrow is Utah versus Utah State. Coverage for that game begins at 7, kickoff at 8 o'clock. What can fans expect from that?
You need to watch Chucky Keaton. A lot of times these guys slide under the radar. Chucky Keaton went for over 300 yards against Utah last year. The great thing about college football, pomp, circumstance, pageantry, That's a big-time state rivalry, guys. Watch Chucky Keaton. He's a big-time player.
Chucky Keaton, what a great name.
Yeah, good big question. Losing Star Latuwi, how is that going to hurt their
It's going to hurt them. Their front seven on Utah is in rough shape, and they gave up way too many yards, over 300 last year. They're in trouble.
And new head,
I'm taking Utah State. Upset.
New head coach for Utah State, yes. Matt Wells, because Gary Anderson's departure to Wisconsin. With that, just a quick reminder, Utah State, Utah, tomorrow coverage begins right here on Fox Sports 1 at 7 o'clock with kickoff at 8 o'clock. Coming up, Mark Sanchez tells Mike Garofalo why even after two subpar seasons, he's staying the course.
Things change, but that never changes. That has to stay constant.
The NFL on Fox is back with a special pregame show live from Times Square. Then the Falcons face the Saints, followed by America's Game of the Week as the Niners battle the Packers. It all kicks off at 11:30 Eastern, Sunday, September 8th.
If you're looking for help relieving heartburn caused by acid reflux disease, relief is at hand. For many, Nexium provides 24-hour heartburn relief and may be available for just $18 a month. There is risk of bone fracture and low magnesium levels. Side effects may include headache, abdominal pain, and diarrhea. If you have persistent diarrhea, contact your doctor right away. Other serious stomach conditions may exist. Don't take Nexium if you take clopidogrel. Relief is at hand for just $18 a month. Talk to your doctor about Nexium.
Wake up to a new, better breakfast. It's Golden Corral's Tastier Than Ever Weekend Breakfast Buffet. For one low price, it's our new buttermilk pancakes, bacon, sausage, signature omelets, and more, juice included, only at Golden Corral. And join us Monday, September 2nd for Labor Day breakfast.
Turn around.
Every now and then I get a little bit hungry and there's nothing good around.
Turn around, Barry.
I finally found the right thing.
You don't really have a rash, do you?
Hope not. I wasn't concerned about it until you guys put me on Front Street.
Front Street.
Are we still saying that?
Thanks for the...
It's always been a part of me to fight for those who couldn't fight for themselves. Whether on my block or around the world, my name is First Lieutenant King, and I move toward the sounds of those who are in need of help.
The few, the proud, the Marines.
Guess who's home early?
Hey, hon. Sit down. We'll make it a foursome.
Experience the intensity of Diablo 3 on the big screen. Diablo 3, coming to consoles September 3rd. Rated M for mature.
Is that my headdress? You can wear it. It's fine.
Where's my wife? She's fine for now.
A bank is something I need. Steal it, and your wife lives.
It goes, she dies.
I'm coming with you.
I need to be told that she is all right!
What are you doing? Stop the car!
I'm gonna do whatever I have to get her back.
Get away. Rated PG-13 starts Friday.
We're watching the Fox Sports Live television show here on Fox Sports 1. Felix Hernandez, 12-4, 2.19 ERA against the rest of the majors this season. His Achilles heel, the Texas Rangers. He has a 5.55 ERA against Texas. He's 0-3 against them this year. Leonis Martin, a deep three-run shot here over the Pepsi sign. Where, oh, where is Crystal Pepsi? I miss it so. Third inning, Rangers up 5-0. Martin Perez getting Henry Blanco to foul one into the stands. And this leads to a tender father-son moment that will be remembered for years. Look at that, boy. I got you the ball. I hate you, kid. I wish you were never born. Oh, I guess I like you now. You're using those binoculars. Those binoculars. Fourth inning, Felix. Martin hits an RBI single. 6-0. Elvis Andrews, double, scores Martin. Next batter, Ian Kinsler, an RBI single. Just a disaster for King Felix. Give up career-high 8 earned runs, and the Rangers win 12-4.
It is Mark Sanchez now at quarterback with second-teamers primarily for the Jets. Floating to his left, under some pressure, looks downfield, fires left sideline at the 45-yard line, and Mark Sanchez is down and hurt.
That was my decision. That's coach's decision all the way. That was my decision. If it wasn't important, then I wouldn't have put him in there. I would not have put Mark in if it wasn't important.
I'm not here to second-guess the coaches. If they call you to play, you better be ready to play, and I was. So I warmed up and went in and played, tried to win.
2 seasons after reaching his second straight AFC Championship game with the Jets, Mark Sanchez is fighting for a starting spot. And an injury late in the third preseason game Saturday put Sanchez's status for the season opener in question. Just more than a week before the injury, Sanchez sat down with Fox Sports NFL insider Mike Garafolo to discuss the pressures of playing in New York.
I felt good all week and just didn't show up in the game. Keep trying to improve, keep studying, keep preparing, and be ready to play next week and see what happens.
Mark, first time in a situation like this where you're competing for your job. How have you adjusted to that?
I think it's honestly similar to positions I've been in, and everybody thinks it's a lot different. But in high school, I competed with somebody for the job. In college at SC, I competed with Mitch Mustaine. Here, my first year with the Jets, I competed with Kellen Clemens. So nothing's changed.
Last year, now behind you, did you have any kind of talk with yourself about moving on from that?
I think every year you move on, and whether you're in an AFC Championship game, you make a great playoff run your first 2 years, or you have years like the last 2 where you don't make the playoffs, you have to kind of put that in its place and put it in a time capsule and move on.
There's been other distractions around this team. Do you kind of think sometimes it's not fair?
I feel like there's the right side and the wrong side of fair. I mean, when things work out for you, you're like, oh, that was pretty fair. You know, but somebody else is out there griping, saying, no, that ain't fair. So it's my job to work with what I can, play the cards I'm dealt, and control everything I possibly can control.
So you've seen the other side of fair then?
Sure, of course.
Your first couple of years?
Absolutely.
Fortunate, is that a good way?
Fortunate, the good side of fair, I mean, whatever you want to call it. There's plenty of other players that were like, man, those first 2 years, that's not fair, he gets to do that. Well, yeah, maybe it wasn't, maybe it was, who knows. But you take those experiences in stride, learn as much as you can from them, and move on.
You led those teams to back-to-back AFC Championship games. Is that guy still here?
Oh, no doubt. I mean, that kind of player never leaves. Things change, but that never changes. That has to stay constant. And, you know, I have all the confidence in the world in myself. I know I can make every throw. I know I can move. I know I can lead this offense. So that's where I'm at.
Do you have to remind yourself, hey, make this fun?
You know, my dad always has a good way of saying it. He's like, you don't have any bad days. He's like, look where you're at. You're in one of the best positions in the world. Is it tough? Yeah. Are some days better than others? Absolutely. There's some not so good days, but it's never a bad day.
You said, look where you are. Look where you are geographically in the New York market.
Yeah.
You still love it?
Oh, of course. Of course.
Even through all the booze, because there's a lot of booze.
No matter what. This whole thing transcends football. It cuts right through the booze. This is a pretty special place. There's nothing like winning here. So we just got to get back on that winning track.
Mark, I've never been booed by 75,000 people. What does it feel like? 75,000 New Yorkers.
You're assuming everyone's booing.
All right, 74,999.
There you go. My dad wasn't booing. No, I mean, look, you got to keep things light and understand they'll be cheering for you. You come back and throw a touchdown, so that's just the way it is.
Do you ever look at this as, you know, hey, you're fighting for your career, buddy?
I mean, I just take each season as it comes. When I need to look at the big picture, I'll look at the big picture, but I wouldn't change. I mean, I really enjoyed the whole ride so far, and I think there's plenty left. Keep smiling, keep having fun, and keep that love for the game.
Our thanks to Mike Garafolo for that sit-down interview with Mark Sanchez. So a lot has happened since the two of them sat down and did that interview. Matt Sims will start in the last preseason game. We wouldn't have seen Mark Sanchez even if he was healthy. So we could possibly see him week one. How important is this season for Mark Sanchez's career?
This is a very big season for him playing for his career, not just playing as a Jet, but playing somewhere else. Right now, I think Mark Sanchez has to put the pressure on himself to protect the football. In a new offense, you have a new coordinator. Get with Marty Mornwig. Come up with a game plan that's comfortable for you and the guys around you. Be effective on the offensive end and show the people that you have the talent to lead them to where they want to go.
If you're Mark Sanchez, what's your relationship like now with Rex Ryan?
Well, you know, I don't know what the dynamic was early on, but I think at this point you have to learn about the business. You have to understand that he's coaching for his job. You have to play for your job. Take care of Mark Sanchez and no one else. Go out, prepare yourself, and show them and show the world that you can play this game.
How far does he have to go with this team to prove that he can stay not only with that team but this league?
Well, I wouldn't focus so much on the Jets. I would focus on if he continued to be a starting quarterback in this league somewhere else. So I think what he has to do is he has to take this team to the second round, maybe back to the AFC Championship. Because if they're a team that's going 8-8, that's it for Mark Sanchez. Easy. He may not finish the season.
Yeah, easier said than done. He did that in his first 2 years, but a lot of people credit the defense to that. Will we see Mark Sanchez in another uniform?
Absolutely. You will see him in another uniform. Will he be a starter? I don't know. But, you know, if he plays well this year, he will.
All right, and their next preseason game is Thursday against the Eagles. Thank you, Donovan.
All right.
Thank you, Donovan. Oh, I just got handed this script for the Get Me That Stat segment. Segment that gets bumped from Fox Sports 1 shows almost as much as Dan and I do, but not tonight. Going into Wednesday, Miguel Cabrera has reached base in 30 straight games, longest streak in the major leagues, and he's now reached base in 31 straight after Wednesday's game against the Athletics. That is 96% of his games, according to producer Zeus. Gave you that information and thoroughly enjoys that segment. Get Me That Stat. Coming up, it's the one.
All right, if you're thinking about getting a new truck, you're probably thinking about fuel economy. Well, you're going to want some torque to go with it. Because unless you're using your truck to deliver pizzas, you ain't getting anything done without it. Torque is power. It pulls trailers, hauls dirt, drags boulders. Torque is what gets the cap off your beer. And only the Ford F-150 with EcoBoost has the best combination of torque and fuel economy. Think about that. This is the 2013 Ford F-150.
When do you crave refreshing iced tea? Twisted Tea wants to know. The next time you want that same satisfying refreshment, but with a kick, grab a Twisted Tea. Twisted Tea, the refreshing hard iced tea that tastes like real iced tea, with a kick.
There's a headless horseman running around Sleepy Hollow.
Who are you?
Ichabod Crane.
This is crazy.
Which makes it no less real.
Stretch it out. Come on, stretch it out. Get it, get it. Pump the arms. Pump the arms. Pump the arms.
It gives you a tremendous sense of pride to own your own business.
We sell ourselves. We sell our name. We sell our image. We want that image to stick.
I'm always introducing myself. I'm always handing out cards.
Vistaprint allows business owners to more effectively and affordably promote their business.
The fact that we use Vistaprint to put our name out in the community in everything that we do just goes to show the level of confidence that we have in Vistaprint.
The easy-to-use tools and templates at Vistaprint.com make it simple to look professional and coordinate your marketing across everything from business cards to websites to postcards and more. See how easy with 250 of our most popular cards. Now new, improved, and still only $10.
250 cards, you can leave a lot of impressions with that.
I have about 20 to 50 business cards on me at any time.
Visit Vistaprint.com, and as an introductory offer, we'll cover the shipping for free.
I'm not sure there is much else you can do for $10 from a marketing standpoint.
Vistaprint.com.
Well, well, well. Who is that?
Christian Young, 26, good-looking prospect, looking to make a move.
Daddy, you're like a super spy, man. You pop in with the info like that. Woo! I'm gonna buy her a kibasi.
No. My sources, they tell me, go with the Pinot.
Pinot for the lady. That's from me. That's right. Pinot for the lady. Take sips. No chug-a-lugging it.
College football is on Fox Sports 1.
Wow!
It all kicks off with the Ford Fox College Football Pregame Show. Then the games begin with West Virginia's home opener. Oregon's high-powered offense takes the field, and Boise State clashes with Washington. Catch all the action this week, starting at 10 Eastern on Fox Sports 1.
Trying to make amends here tonight.
Chris Sale looking for a second straight 10-win season. We flash back to Friday. Sale trashed the dugout and allowed a career-high 4 home runs, 11-5 loss to the Rangers. Wednesday, Sale healing in the retros, which I love. Awesome. Brandon Bard swinging. Chris Carter looking. Jake Elmore swinging. Sale finished with 12 strikeouts. The retro White Sox win it 6-1.
That baseball was not going to get down the right field line.
Go ahead and win your third Gold Glove.
This is why he is a Golden Glover.
Chance for two. Did Freeman hold it? Yes.
Trout coming on, dives, and makes the catch.
Light. Oh, speared by Gorzolani. He's going to get a double play out of it.
Speed also pays off on defense.
BJ on the run. Makes a diving catch. There's a fine play.
Knew that one wouldn't make it.
Yeah, those are the honorable mentions for the one. You helped us pick the best plays by tweeting us at Fox Sports Live.
Or if you just want to send us tweets, tell us how much you hate Jay's ill-fitting toupee. Don't forget to include the hashtag, the one.
Yeah, it doesn't fit. I knew it. I should have asked you before the show. Derek Jeter, number 2, from his knee. Derek Jeter.
U.S. Open, first round, first set. Andy Murray, no look, overhead winner.
He's 26, I know that by watching a crap.
It's a good night. Great nights for me. He's got meat in the face repeatedly. I didn't even realize it was in a UFC fight. Bud Norris with the one. Getting Dustin Pedroia first.
On the 50th anniversary of Dr. Martin Luther King's historic speech, Donovan McNabb discusses how Dr. King's powerful dream touches the world of sports.
The show where sports and entertainment meet has arrived. Introducing Crowd Goes Wild.
Great team, never rests.
You wouldn't put these guys together in a normal circumstance.
I'm excited to work with Katie Nolan. She's definitely cuter than these two.
The ladies' man. Is he in this room right now?
Totally original and totally unpredictable.
I'm going to bring the locker room into television, and they're going to hate me for it.
Sports talk just got more colorful. Crowd Goes Wild, weekdays at 5 on Fox Sports 1.
They'll see you before you see them. Cops are cracking down on drinking and driving. Drive sober or get pulled over.
Golden Corral just made the weekend better than ever again. Our $12.99 premium prime rib and shrimp weekend is back. It's endless prime rib, our best jumbo butterfly shrimp, and our new bone-in catfish and catfish fillets. It's our premium prime rib and shrimp weekend only at Golden Corral.
In the future, machines will enforce the law.
Meet Morp Z, robot captain, engage.
But in the meantime, we've got the detectives of Brooklyn Nine-Nine.
That's a terrible robot voice.
Yep.
Brooklyn Nine-Nine premieres next month on Fox.
It's a good one.
It's really awkward,
awesome.
Actually. Yeah.
So weird. When did you guys find out you had one?
Just now from you.
When he ripped it off last night.
Play track one.
All of us.
the next Harley Davidson Motorcycles.
I talk big, right? And at the dealership, I was trying to hold my own, and it's kind of tough.
TrueCar really took the anxiety out of the car buying process.
When you use TrueCar.com, you get a certificate, and it shows you a fair price.
I felt confident going in on my own and closing the deal on my own.
TrueCar makes it a lot easier to go in by yourself.
I don't need to bring a dude with me.
When buying a car, get guaranteed savings and a hassle-free experience. Visit TrueCar.com.
Monday Night Fights on Fox Sports 1. Luis Collazo stares down Alan Sanchez. Monday on Fox Sports 1.
Welcome back, everybody. Wednesday marked the 50-year anniversary of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s speech of I Have a Dream. Donovan, what did that speech mean to your life personally?
The speech really went deep into me, and giving an opportunity to go to school with everyone else and receive the same education, and also fulfilling a dream, you know, going into Division I school at Syracuse University, receive my degree just like everybody else in communications, and being able to have an opportunity to be here today to speak in front of the masses of what I know in sports.
So we know his speech, the impact that it had politically, socially, but also in athletics. Is there one individual that stands out for you in the athletic world that really paved the way for your future career?
Growing up in the city of Chicago, Michael Jordan was a guy that I idolized, not only because of the things he was able to do on the court, but off the court, having that opportunity to be a role model and expand to the masses out there of how it was important to be that guy, and to also give back and show your support to others, mm-hmm. charitable endeavors, and make sure that you touch someone's life and inspire them to be the best at anything.